12, we saw Narendra Modi's cabinet take shape just a while back, and what you see on your television screens are BJP supporters and Modi supporters in Nelamangala watching the oath-taking ceremony on a big screen and rejoicing and celebrating, even as their leader has been appointed as the Prime Minister of the country. Well, Mishashwini, now coming back to you, speaking about the senior leaders, more often than not have been termed as the sidelined leaders, M.M. Joshi. You also have L.K. Advani for that matter. How do you think BJP will place them now? To ensure that they are satisfied, they are happy, there are no problems within the BJP and there is no friction all the time.
I really don't know. I think L.K. Advani would probably continue as the chairman of the
NDA,
of the National Democratic Alliance, and I'm not sure about M.M. Joshi. Probably keep him in a senior guiding light advisorial capacity for BJP as a party, because if there is no major challenge to be overcome by not pitching them into the limelight, then there is no overt reason for Narendra Modi or anybody in his government to even think on those lines. As of now, everything seems to be hunky-dory, so they probably just leave them where they are.
That's right.
But Aparna might have better information than I do on what they will do with their leading lights.
It's not about information, it's just that we are a democratic setup, and whatever we do, it's done in consultation as a party and taking the senior leaders also into confidence. There have been the spine of the party, so definitely they'll be guiding the future of this government too.
Professor, coming to you, how do you think the Narendra Modi government will accommodate both these senior leaders, M.M. Joshi as well as L.K. Advani, in a very respectable position and make sure that there's no friction?
I could get your point here.
Professor, how do you think the Modi government can make sure that both these senior leaders, M.M. Joshi, L.K. Advani and others who haven't been taken into the government, can be accommodated in a very respectable position and make sure there's no friction?
Okay, you are talking about how to accommodate elders with the others, is it?
Yes.
That was your question?
Yes.
Okay, look at Modi will be supported by the elders right now, with Rajnath Singh, who took the oath immediately after Prime Minister, followed by Sushma Swaraj, who is known as the supporter of L.K. Advani. Then you have Arun Jaitley, Gadkari. In fact, four people are known as the inner circle of, they are going to be the inner circle of Narendra Modi. But at the same time, you need to understand there will be two or three layers of, advisor to Narendra Modi to govern the country, beginning with this core group, which has the link with its headquarters back in Nagpur or somewhere else. But at the same time, this core group would definitely try to advise PM on major issues, and also try to see that even the allies would be taken into confidence while governing. Look at the way the allies have been taken into account. At the same time, you need to understand the fact that if you look at the cabinet, there are hardliners one side. You find the hardliners also, like Uma Bharti is there.
Well, Professor, I'll just place you on hold.
Let's listen to what the newly inducted Cabinet Minister Siddhartha Gowda has to say in just a bit. But these are state BJP leaders congratulating him, Ashoka as well as Jagadish Shetty.
Namma Rajyada Pakshada Ella Pramukara Sahakaradinda. ವಿಶೇಷವಾಗಿ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿನ ನಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲ ಆ ಒಂದು ಟೀಮಿಂದ ನಾನು ಭಾರಿ ದೊಡ್ಡದ ಅಂತರದ ಗೆಲುವನ್ನು ಸಾಧಿಸಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಯಿತು. ಮತ್ತು ಇವತ್ತು ನರೇಂದ್ರ ಮೋದಿಯವರು ನಮ್ಮನ್ನು ಕೇಂದ್ರದ ಸಂಪುಟಕ್ಕೆ, ಸನ್ಮಾನ್ಯ ನರೇಂದ್ರ ಮೋದಿಯವರು ಕೇಂದ್ರ ಸಂಪುಟಕ್ಕೆ ಸೇರಿಸಿಕೊಂಡಿರುವಂಥದ್ದು ಒಂದು ಹೆಚ್ಚಿನ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿಯನ್ನು ನನಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದೆ. ಹಿಂದೆ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿಯಾಗಿ ರಾಜ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು 11 ತಿಂಗಳು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿದಂಥದ್ದು ಮತ್ತು ಪಕ್ಷದ ಅಧ್ಯಕ್ಷನಾಗಿ ಮತ್ತು ವಿರೋಧ ಪಕ್ಷದ ಮೇಲ್ಮನೆ ನಾಯಕನಾಗಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿರುವಂತಹ ಸಂದರ್ಭಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ನನ್ನ ಎಲ್ಲವನ್ನ ಪರಿಗಣಿಸಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಇದನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಭಾವಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ಇಡೀ ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಹಿತಾಸಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಕಾಪಾಡುವಂಥದ್ದು, ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿನ ಹಿತಾಸಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನ ಸನ್ಮಾನ್ಯ ಅನಂತಕುಮಾರ್ ಮತ್ತು ಪಿಸಿ ಮೋಹನ್ರ ಜೊತೆ ಸೇರಿಕೊಂಡು ಅಲ್ಲಿಯ ನಮ್ಮ ನಾಯಕರು ಅಶೋಕರು, ಮುನಿರಾಜರು, ಕೃಷ್ಣಪ್ಪರು ಇವರೆಲ್ಲ ತಂಡದ ಜೊತೆ ಸೇರಿಕೊಂಡು ನಾವು ಮುಂದಿನ ದಿನಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಯಶಸ್ಸು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಸನ್ಮಾನ್ಯ ಜಗದೀಶ್ ಶೆಟ್ಟರು, ನಮ್ಮ ಕೆಳಮನೆಯ ನಾಯಕರು ಇಡೀ ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿಯನ್ನು ಮೊನ್ನೆ ಹೀಗೆ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗ ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಜವಾಬ್ದಾರಿಯನ್ನ ಅಶೋಕರು ಮತ್ತು ಜಗದೀಶ್ ಶೆಟ್ಟರು ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ವಹಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ತೇವೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುವಂತದನ್ನು ಮೊನ್ನೆ ಕೂಡ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆದರೆ ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಹಿತಾಸಕ್ತಿಯ ಜೊತೆ ದೇಶದ ಕೆಲಸ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡುವಂತದನ್ನು ನಾನು ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ.
I will accept it and I will do the best possible from my side. मुझे ये मीडिया में चल रहा है मगर so far I have not intimated with any portfolio so far. Not only for me, for any of the cabinet members they have not allotted the portfolios. I hope that by tomorrow evening we will get the portfolios and afterwards we will go ahead with our jobs.
Three cabinet minister, you are from Karnataka. Now Mr. B. Yedurappa.
No, two cabinet ministers, one state minister.
Are you demanding Mr. Yedurappa is also inducted in, because he is not inducted yet?
See, it is this question does not arise. It is the prerogative power of the prime minister. Who should be there in the cabinet? Who should be there in the cabinet and what portfolio should be allotted? That is the prerogative of the Prime Minister. So how I can say answer for all these questions?
Thank you.
Well, that was D.V. Sadananda Gowda there going on to thank people for their support, and he also clarified that there is absolutely no news of which portfolio he will be getting, although media reports clearly indicate that he will be picked up for the Railway Ministry portfolio, which is a very, very plum portfolio, and it is probably the biggest portfolio that any Karnataka MP will be getting. Well, we'll slip into a short break now, but stay tuned, we'll be right back. Well, right here in the News Live Studios, we're tracking the newly formed cabinet of Narendra Modi. 23 cabinet ministers, close to 10 ministers of state with independent charge, and 10 other ministers of state have been sworn in into the cabinet. And even as we speak, the gala dinner is underway at the Rashtrapati Bhavan. And coming back to our guests tonight, Ms. Shashwati, now we have discussed the portfolios for various of these ministers. We'll come back to that. Well, let's listen to what Shivraj Singh Chauhan had to say after the function.
आनंद मैंने पहले भी बताया, हम लोगों के लिए आनंद का क्षण है, प्रदेश की जनता के लिए उत्सव का क्षण है, और हम ये देखते हैं कि देश प्रगति के पथ पर बहुत तेजी से आगे बढ़ेगा. केवल नई सरकार नहीं बनी, एक नए युग का आरंभ हुआ है. ये युग विकास का युग होगा, ये जन कल्याण का युग होगा, ये आम आदमी के कल्याण का युग होगा, और देश प्रगति की नई ऊंचाइयां छुएगा, और मध्य प्रदेश भी और तेज गति से आगे बढ़ेगा. वैसे तो जो मंत्री हैं पूरे देश के हैं, कोई मध्य प्रदेश का या और किसी प्रदेश के मंत्री नहीं होते, तो वो पूरे देश का ध्यान रखेंगे, लेकिन मध्य प्रदेश को भी उचित नेतृत्व दिया है, उसके लिए धन्यवाद.
सर, बीजेपी काफी मजबूत हालत में, तो क्या बहुत ज्यादा डिमांड आपकी बढ़ गई है, बहुत ज्यादा विश्वास है कि खुलकर के आप एमपी के विकास के लिए और क्या क्या?
नहीं, हमारी डिमांड केवल जो न्याय यूपीए की सरकार में नहीं मिला, हम उन्हीं मुद्दों को रखेंगे. एक्स्ट्रा मध्य प्रदेश को कुछ नहीं चाहिए, क्योंकि हम जानते हैं बाकी प्रदेश भी तो हमारे प्रदेश हैं.
चार लोगों से संतुष्ट हैं आप?
अरे, हम तो हमेशा संतुष्ट रहते हैं, संतुष्ट कभी नहीं रहते.
धन्यवाद
सर. आज से अच्छे दिन आगे क्या?
पूरे देश को भी लाभ मिलेगा, मध्य प्रदेश को भी.
आराम से. Well, that was Shivraj Singh Chauhan. Of course, as we discussed earlier, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and Gujarat, where the BJP has a very, very strong hold, there is minimal representation, close to three representations from Madhya Pradesh, in fact. One is that of Gehlot, Uma Bharati, in fact, from Uttar Pradesh. The other one is Sushma Swaraj from Vidisha constituency. So, though that it is being speculated that Vasundhara Raje is unimpressed with the kind of representation that Rajasthan has had, and similar is the case with Madhya Pradesh and Gujarat. But of course, Narendra Modi has taken these decisions, keeping an eye on the upcoming assembly polls in different states and giving them adequate representation, especially the states where BJP has recently made inroads.
Also, coming back to cabinet allocation, you had D.V. Sadanand Gowda saying that they haven't been informed about the kind of portfolio they will get. But definitely, if you go by what they're saying, railways, which means a huge push for D.V. Sadanand Gowda politically for his career.
No, absolutely. To begin with, railways is a portfolio that has been with Karnataka.
Karnataka, yes.
So it will continue with Karnataka. That's the point number one. Point number two, you know, for Sadanand Gowda, this is certainly a huge elevation in his political career. No doubts about that.
In terms of other portfolios, do you think it is a wise idea to give one person two huge portfolios? How it is being speculated now, you are saying Arun Jaitley might get defense and finance. Do you think that will be...
See, that's in the realm of speculation.
Yes.
Like I was telling you earlier, that seems an unlikely situation, reasonably speaking. You know, I'm not suggesting this government can't do it, but I'm saying reasonably speaking, you don't take two huge portfolios and put them under one person. But considering that there has not been a serious talk of defense being allocated to any one individual, there is a high chance that the PMO might want to hold on to the defense portfolio, interact with the defense chiefs directly for a while, considering, you know, the mayhem that has happened within the defense forces in the recent past. I think there will be a need for the civilian authority and the defense authorities to actually develop a more healthy relationship. And Narendra Modi would be somebody who would be interested in that. So it's unlikely that two large portfolios will go to the same minister. However, large portfolios which have synergies might be merged into one umbrella portfolio.
Like the transport or the energy.
Yeah, whether it's transport, energy, you know, tourism and civil aviation, whether it's shipping, transportation, you know, surface transport,
yes.
Shipping, civil aviation, that's a possible merger. Civil aviation, tourism is a possible merger. Energy, power, coal is a possible merger. So, you know, you would be looking at maybe commerce and industry and, you know, external and trade would be a possible
under
merger.
Under one umbrella,
so,
yes.
Yeah. So it really depends on how these portfolios are structured. And just because you merge doesn't mean they merge in toto. You know, the portfolios themselves can be redefined. The ministries themselves can be redefined because there are parts which overlap. So you would have to draw a line and say, okay, this is what belongs to this ministry.
Yes.
When you say you're merging, you also have to consider the role of the ministers of state, because
then
you have
multiple ministers
of state and a single cabinet minister. So you have those many distinctions there. So
comes back to the point of control.
Yes.
Yes.
You see, when you're looking at synergistic ministries, often industry ministry wants to give a clearance, but environment ministry is stopping it.
So the PMO will take the final.
You know,
call.
These have happened in the past, that ministries have not worked together to take common decisions. So in this particular case, if you have synergistic ministries which come under wide umbrellas, then nobody can give you a different reason for not having acted upon
one particular thing.
Because the same minister
the
is
same
having
person.
To look at it from three different perspectives, helped by the MOS. So structurally, definitely, on paper, lends to a lot of efficiency.
Right. So, we'll